Hello, this video is how to make Gmail or Bison Connect or Google Apps for Government make the email client look more familiar. And this is aimed specifically at people who are used to using either Outlook or Lotus Notes. And there's some things that you can do, and some labs and some settings that you can do in the Google environment to help make it look more familiar, to add some of the tools that you might be used to using, and to make it overall a more familiar and pleasant experience. So what I have here is a default inbox. It's ordered from newest to oldest. Google also has something called the conversation view. I like to also call it the accordion view, where it's basically like this message here. You see a message string here and it has a number next to it. There's another one here. What that number means is it means that this single row actually represents 8 different messages back and forth from the original to the most recent message, all contained in one row. So it takes that conversation, the original and each reply after it, and compresses it like an accordion into a single row. In order to see those messages, you would click on it. And you can see here it has the older messages. So here's the original, here's the newest. And the older messages are compressed in the middle. And to see those, you would click on that to view it. Some people love this feature, some people don't like it. Outlook and Lotus Notes don't have that feature. So if you don't like the accordion or conversation view, it's easy to turn it off. The easiest way to it is you just click Settings, which is the little gearbox looking thing in the upper right corner. Then you go to Settings. And then in the Settings menu, look for Conversation View and click Conversation View off. Now, this Settings General tab, I'll talk about more in another video, but you can control a ton of things here. For this purpose, we're only going to talk about the Conversation View. But there's some other great things in here that you can turn on and off, including things like Signature and the in and out of office reminder. But after you change the conversation view, hit Save Changes. Once you do that, you'll notice it takes you back to the inbox, and now all those messages that were previously compressed together, the original and all the replies, are now each its own row. So this is much more familiar if you're used to using Outlook or Lotus Notes. Another thing is Outlook users especially are familiar with having a little mini calendar in the corner here. That mini calendar is really helpful if you need to, see what day of the week it is, or if you want to see when Thursday of next week, what, number of the calendar that is. With the Google default, your chat window is actually in that space. So all the people who you commonly email can also be chat with. So that isn't necessarily the best place to have your chat window if you want it to look more familiar as an Outlook or Lotus Notes user. So how do you change those things? Another thing that you might want to do is also have the preview window. In Outlook, you were able to have really it kind of let you open a message and read it without actually opening it all the way. And it was a preview that let you split your inbox. So when you clicked on an individual message, you could read the message without having it take over your entire screen. The default with Gmail is when you click on a message, your entire screen shows you that message there. So what you would really want is to add the preview there. So let me show you the settings and labs that make this all possible. So what are labs? So we're going to go back to the gear and back into settings. Now across the settings you have several options. You have general, where we just were to change the conversation view. If you keep looking across, you'll see labs. Now I'll talk a little more about labs in another video, but labs are basically extensions and additional functionality in Gmail that aren't released with the core functionality. Some of these things are experimental, so they may not always work, but a lot of times they're features that people like to turn on and off based on personal preference. So labs are a great way to customize without making everyone have to use the same features. So for example, in this case, what we're going to want to do is we're going to turn on very specific ones. So as you scroll down, you're going to look for one called the Google Calendar Gadget. You're going to want to turn on that one. You're also going to want to turn on Right Side Chat. Where is it? Right side chat. You're also going to want to turn on quick links, and you're also going to want to turn on the mark as read button. So again, I turned on the calendar gadget, the mark as read button, right side chat, and quick links. Once you've turned on those labs, you're going to want to click on save changes. Very important to do that. It'll redraw your inbox, and now you're back in your inbox, but it's changed the layout. You notice that the chat is now over here on the right side, so right side chat does. And it also brought up that mini calendar thing. However, you don't see it. Well, Google has a feature down here, these three little dots. Turn the gadgets on and off. So by clicking on it, I've now added the quick link gadget and the calendar gadget to my view here. So the calendar gadget actually is pretty cool because it gives me a view of all the meetings that I have. But if you click on options and you click show mini calendar, that'll bring up the mini calendar like you're familiar with seeing in Outlook. So it gives you a highlight on the day of the week, but it also shows you other days. Another cool thing is you can actually hit this add button and you can add a meeting directly to your calendar from this little shortcut here. We'll talk a little bit more about that in another video, but that's another cool little feature there. So the calendar also lets you view the different calendars that you have available to you. You have your own, but in case you share a calendar with someone else, you can also view their calendar events. Quick links. What does quick link do? Well, quick link is like the shortcuts that Lotus Notes users are used to using. So for example, let's say there's an email message that you often refer back to. Let's say it has an important link to a document or it has an important instruction. In this case, I'm going to say it's this message right here. The way to add a quick link is by adding that quick link lab. You now have this feature over here, and you simply open up the message that you want to make a shortcut to and hit add quick link. It's going to ask you to name it, so I'm going to call this something like links to my videos. Oops. And then I'm going to hit OK. And now you see it added a link over here on the left. So now no matter where I am, I can be in another message, I can be in the inbox. If I click this quick link, it automatically will open that email. So it's another really cool feature there. So one other feature we're missing is the preview. And the preview is here on the top menu. It's this button here that's called split pane mode. So it's essentially the exact same thing as preview. So you have two options. No split turns it off, but you also have vertical split, which puts your inbox on the left and the message that you're looking at on the right. So if I click on that message, now here I'm reading the message without it taking over my entire screen. Outlook users will be more familiar with horizontal split, which is the default in Outlook, where now the preview is here at the bottom and all of my inbox messages are here at the top. So I click on it there. Now there's my message preview. So you can play around with this and get it to look exactly the way you want. Remember, you have many inbox types. You can have the default. You can also sort by importance or whether you've started. There's another video in the series which will talk about these more. But I invite you to play around with it and turn labs on and off until you get the interface to look exactly how you want and you're comfortable with it. Thanks for watching. If you like this video and you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thank you.